Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Stamp and Chat. I'm Gina K, and I'm so excited to see you all here tonight. I was just scrolling through some of the comments already, and it's exciting to see that many of you have joined me from all over the world. And we are going to have some fun tonight. I have, today is Flashback Friday. Tonight is Flashback Friday. And that means I'm either going to use some old stamp sets or I'm going to use an old technique. And tonight I'm actually going to use both. I'm going back into the vault of stamp sets and use some of the old stamp sets that I've been using lately. And I'm going to revisit a technique that was probably one of the earlier techniques that I ever did on my YouTube channel well over 10 years ago. So I'm excited to share that with you tonight. For those of you that are newer stampers, you're really going to like it. It's really going to be fun. And for those of you that are experienced stampers, it might remind you of something that you used to like to do and you want to do it again. Well, tonight's topic here on Stamp and Chat, tonight's topic is a doozy. It is guilt, right? So talking about guilt, I got to tell you, guilt is a big problem for me. I just want to clarify right away that I am not a therapist. I'm not a psychologist, but I do see one twice a week. So I am sharing some of the things that I have learned from my very own therapist on the topic of guilt. So I'm gonna just talk a little bit about that and start with a quote. So my first quote tonight, the quote that I'm gonna start the night with is, and maybe you guys can relate to this, guilt is to the spirit what pain is to the body, right? So it's a painful heart almost. It's a painful mind where you walk around all the time feeling heavy, like you did something wrong and you just can't seem to shake it. And you know, it's interesting because no amount of guilt can change the past and no amount of worry can change the future. Yet we feel guilty like our job. And I know a lot of you out there who might be moms or grandmoms or aunts, or you have little ones that are somehow in your care. Maybe you're a daycare provider. We have this crazy kind of guilt. Some of the things that you might be feeling guilty about right now are being healthy. I mean, I've actually woken up in the morning and said, oh man, you know, I watch the news and I think of people who are sick with COVID and I feel guilty that I'm healthy. I feel guilty sometimes that I'm happy. Sometimes we feel guilty just because we have enough. Even if you're not very wealthy, you can even feel guilty just because you have enough when you know how much people are struggling right now, right? You might feel guilty about, I know a lot of you are homeschooling, so you might feel guilty about being a good mom. But let me just tell you that the fact that you're even worried about it means you already are. So don't worry about that. You might feel guilty for saying no. I feel guilty for saying no all the time. It happens all the time. Somebody might call me or text me and say, hey, you want to FaceTime? I just don't want to. But I don't want to say, I just don't want to FaceTime right now. So I say, oh, I'm sorry, I'm in a meeting, or I'm, you know, because you feel guilty. You don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. So I have an answer for that. And I'm going to wait until the end of tonight's little show here to talk about that. And I was going over it with my therapist and giving him my mile-long list of all of the things that I'll feel guilty about. He said one sentence that changed my life. So I'm going to say that sentence to you at the end of the show, and that's going to be actually my closing quote. It's not really a quote, it's a sentence, but hopefully you will use it going forward and it will really make a difference for you. Now, let's talk about my pajamas. These are not really pajamas. This is a sweatshirt. And I realized tonight when I was rummaging through my drawers because it's pajama night, that I don't really have any other pajamas except the ones that I wore the last two or last three Flashback Fridays. So I need to get some new pajamas. So I would love you guys to let me know where you like to get your jammies from. I like in the summer, I wear a t-shirt and shorts to bed. In the winter, I wear a sweatshirt and yoga pants to bed. And the only reason why I have the pajamas that I have is because I went to a girls' retreat and we have a pajama night, and I felt guilty that I didn't have pajamas, so I bought them. See, that's the guilt again. So I bought a pair, and luckily I had them for our pajama night, but I'm going to get some new ones. But this is actually what I woke up in this morning, so I don't look that much different than I did last night before I went to bed. I did brush my hair, but that's about it. Okay, so I want to show you guys something. Do you remember a couple of weeks ago on one of my lives, I said that I wanted to take that Sunday and plant some seeds? Well, I want to show you. I'm so excited. Check it out. Look at my babies. Look at them. They're growing. This is my arugula. Isn't it cute? All these little happy little plants growing. This is just God's message that life goes on, that you can put a seed in the dirt and something grows. So far my arugula has come up, my spinach has come up, and my kale has come up. Kale in our house is known as angry lettuce. It is coming up and it's doing well. So I have two little broccoli sprouts and everything else is still incubating in there. So I'm excited. Well, tonight's technique is an oldie but goodie. One of my favorite techniques that I barely do anymore. So I want to talk about it. And it's called Smackin Acetate. And I have a video. I have a couple of videos called Smackin Acetate. And that's because what you do in this technique is you take a piece of acetate. And you all have acetate right now. Don't think you don't have it, because this is what I use for acetate. I take a stamp sheet and I take the back piece of the stamp sheet, and that's my acetate. You can also use your stamp pockets. That's acetate. And you can also use any packaging, something that you bought that had a clear panel in it. You can use that as well. You can also use any slick surface. So if you have a glass mat, that works just as well. But back then, we didn't have all the fancy glass mats and things. And so we went out and we bought sheets of acetate because we made a lot of shaker cards. And this is what we used. So I'm going to use that tonight. Now, a lot of people now call this watercolor backgrounds and different things like that. But I really think that the way that we do this is really fun. So that's what we're going to do tonight. We're going to make a couple of cards using it. So I have a little bit of watercolor paper. Now, you don't have to use watercolor paper for this, but it works a little bit better because it can warp the paper a lot if it's really, really wet. So I like using watercolor paper for it. Now, this is the Tim Holtz watercolor paper by Ranger. And I like this paper a lot because it's got a rough side. And this is the side that most people use, but it's also got a kind of a smooth side on the back. So you can use either side of this paper and it works really well. Now, I was digging around because I only have a couple sheets of this left, and I found this in a drawer. I don't know where I got it. I don't know whose it is. I think it possibly could be Alicia's and she just left it here, but I took it. I just ripped out a piece of it and then cut it with my paper cutter. And this little thing can just pop right back on there. I've done that a couple times today. But this is a good one. I like this paper too. I used this earlier, so this is fun to use. So either one of these, you can just see there's a little bit of a difference in the color. I don't know if that shows up, but the Tim Holtz watercolor paper is really nice and bright white. And I do like that because it really looks nice with our cardstock. So I'm going to start with my paper cutter here, and I'm going to cut a piece of this cardstock to 3 3/4 inch. Maybe I'll cut it a little bigger. I'll cut it 4 inches. by 5 1/4 inches. Now, this isn't going to be my final cut, but I just want to get it a little bit smaller so I don't have to, you know, put too much ink down here. You can see my light fixture head and my camera on my acetate. So there's a couple ways that you can do this. You can do this with water-based markers. So here are some Tombow markers that I like to use for this technique. There's other markers out there that work, Barbie markers, Zig, clean color brush markers work, the Stampin' Up! Water-based markers work, whatever you have that's water-based. And you'll know it's water-based because if you scribble it onto the acetate and then you spritz it with water, it'll kind of, you know, spread. Okay, so you can use that. You can also use reinkers, and I have a few Gina K Designs reinkers. You want to make sure that they're water-based reinkers, so dye reinkers work really well with this technique. And then what I'm going to use for my first card are ink cubes. Let me get this out of here. This keeps falling in the way. These are my little notes for tonight. So I have a bunch of different ink cube colors here, and ink cubes are really good to work with this technique. So I'll try a couple different things tonight, and we'll see how it all goes. And then we'll pick what we like, and we'll make a card out of it. Okay, so I think I'm going to start with ink cubes, and I'm going to use Moonlit Fog, maybe Bubblegum, and Turquoise Sea. Let's see what that combination looks like. That seems like it would be a nice bright combination. Now you can use really bright, vibrant colors, or you can really, you know, you can use really soft colors too. So I have my piece of acetate here, and I'm going to start at the top with some Moonlit Fog. And I'm just going to take my ink cube, and I'm going to just kind of go across the acetate like this, and you can smush it if you want. Then I'm going to take some pink, and I'm going to do another row of pink. And then I'm going to take some Turquoise Sea, and I'm going to do a row of Turquoise Sea. Now, if we just left it like that, I don't think it would look all that great. But here I have the Tim Holtz Distress Sprayer. I've had this thing for so long, it's actually starting yellow. That means it's really, really old, and it still works great. And it's got a nice, thin, fine mist of spray. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the sprayer, and I'm going to spray water on it. I always like to start my sprayer like off to the side. So I'll show you, like I take it and I just kind of like spray it into the air. And can you see, I don't know if you can see this, but if you spray it kind of like not full, it's a little more blotchy. But if you give it the full quick spray, it's very fine. So I'm going to use it on the very fine setting. So I'm going to spray the water. And then I'm going to spray into it a little bit just to kind of move the colors into each other. Just a little bit, not a lot, but a little. Okay. And then I'm going to take my piece of cardstock and I'm going to just put it down and give it a little twist and then just lay it down. And then I'm going to pick it up and see what happened. You see that? Now, I really love the empty parts. So if it's empty, just leave it because it really looks good. Now I'm going to take my my Wagner heat tool and I'm going to dry this. I'm going to try to push any of that ink that's down there up into the other color a little bit. But this dries pretty quickly. And you can go back and you can add more colors. So if you say, oh, I really want some more gray up at the top, I want that gray to look a little bit darker, you can go back and add more. And I'll show you what I mean. So I'm going to clean this with a paper towel. You can also use your tidy towel to clean it. I'm just going to get that off of there. And you can go back and add a little bit more gray So I'm going to add some more gray over here. And then I might add a little bit more pink just right here. Maybe a little more blue. And then I'm going to spritz it. Kind of move it around a little bit, and then I'm going to just lay it down again. See, that gives me more color. And it gives me more of a mottled look, and I love that. So let me dry that. This stuff really kind of looks a mess, and you might not trust yourself when you first do it. You might not think that you did it right, or it looks like it's not going to look like anything nice. But wait until you see how pretty it looks. So let me just dry up that excess, and then I'm going to put that off to the side. Now, I have a couple tissues here. I'm not sick. I just have tissues everywhere because I'm a mom, and moms always have tissues everywhere. Okay. So now the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to do another piece. Now let's try this. This was the Langdon not cold pressed grain fin watercolor cardstock. I have no idea. If you want to know what any of this means, you've got to tune into Lydia Fiedler and Kathy Rakusin. They do a kind of where they talk and they watercolor and they color. They do something like that on, I think, Tuesdays and Sundays. And they can answer all of your questions. I don't know any of those answers. I just know that it works. That's my expertise. I tried it and it worked. So now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take a couple of these colors. I think I'm going to use this orange. This is 933. I'm going to use this pink, which is 723. And I'll use this blue, which is 452. Maybe I'll use a bright orange. I think I'll use this one. This looks like from the cap that it's going to be brighter. This is 925. And again, these colors don't really have names. So this, I'm just going to scribble. There we go. And then I'll scribble a little of this pink. This is 723. And then I will scribble some of this blue, which is 452. Oh, that's pretty. Okay. So now I'm going to spritz that with water. And then I'm going to make it run a little bit into each other here. Okay. And then I'm going to put this paper on. I don't even know which side I used because they both look the same on this cardstock. Ooh, that's pretty. That would be really pretty to hand letter on, wouldn't it? If you knew how to do that, which I don't, but I think that would be really pretty. So I'm going to dry this, and then I might add a little bit extra in there so I can add some more texture. Although we could try this just like it is. Maybe we'll do that. But see that orange splotch in there? I think I like that, and I want a little bit more of that look. So maybe I'll just go back and just go over this side here. That looks like, ooh, I think I still need more. So let me dry it and add some more. I do love the mix of colors. Do just a little more. And the blue. And again. And we'll lay it down. I like that twist motion too. All right, this one wants to be more smooth, so we're going to do it smooth. There must be a reason. It could be the paper too. So you got to try different papers with it and see which ones work the way you want them to. But I still think this is going to be pretty, so we're going to make something out of it. All right, this is almost dry. It's very warpy paper because it's a lot thinner than the other cardstock. That's going to require a lot more tape. But I think if I hold it flat like this, I can help flatten it out a bit. Okay, so that one's pretty. So you can see how different these are, right? But they're really, really pretty. Okay, so now I think we should try one more. And I'm just going to scan down here and see if anybody has any kinds of questions. No, I think you guys are much more knowledgeable than I am. You're actually answering each other's questions, which I love that when I look back and I see somebody asked a question. Oh my gosh, that just makes me so happy when you guys jump in and help each other. So now I'm going to, well, I'm going to welcome everybody because we have a lot more people here than the last time I had my face in the screen. So welcome to Stampin' Chat with Gina K. I am so excited to see you all. We are playing with the Smackin Acetate technique. And I have a piece of acetate here and I've got some reinkers and water-based markers and ink cubes to play with. So I'm going to go back to the Tim Holtz cardstock, and I will go back to full screen because I know that I can get lost and then all of a sudden I'm off the screen. So I'm going to cut this down again to 4 1/4 inches or 4 3/4 inches by 3.5 this time. So this one will be a little bit smaller. And this one I want to do, I could use reinkers, but I've got these ink cube colors here and I don't have this color in a reinker and I want to use it. So I'm going to use Peach Bellini. You could use a full ink pad too if you wanted. You just smash it down there. And then I'm going to use some, I'm going to use this turquoise C again. You wouldn't think that would look good together, but I think it's going to. And then I'm going to use more moonlit fog down here at the bottom. Okay. I like the way these look like really interesting sunsets. Okay. You know, and if that looks like it's too much of a blotch, you can always absorb a little bit of it. And then I'm going to put that on top. All right, what do I have? Ooh, that's pretty. I am a big fan of the white space. Okay, so I think the ink cubes work the best for me, but I've used the markers too. And if you go back and look at some of my old videos, you will see that I used markers to do this technique and I got a lot of white space. It's different every time. It really is. It's absolutely different every time. I'm going to add a little bit more because I'm loving the color. All right, so a little bit more Peach Bellini. Definitely more of the turquoise C. And a little more moonlit fog right in here. Okay. And then squirt, squirt. And then I'm going to just touch it fast and pull it up and see what that, yes, that is cool. Okay. I get a little excited when I'm stamping. And even though I know you're out there, I got to tell you, even if you weren't out there, I'd still be screaming and being excited about what happens. Techniques are fun when you technique and it just looks cool. It's just so much fun. Okay, so now I'm just going to do a little cleanup here. So we're going to make some of these cards, but I'm going to trim them down. And the reason why I went a little bit bigger with them is so that I would have room to trim them down before I actually turn them into cards. So I'm going to put this piece of acetate off to the side. And I'm going to get a new piece of cardstock here because this one's really wet. Not that it matters, but I like my space to look a little prettier. Okay. And then I'm going to trim this down before I start turning it into a card. So I'm going to trim this one down. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller, but I really want to keep as much as I can because I really like the white space. So I'm going to cut a quarter of an inch off of the side here. And I don't want to lose that, but I think I'm going to have to lose a little of it because I'm going to make it a little smaller, quarter of an inch off the side here. It's okay. I did play with this earlier today because I actually spent time just playing in my stamp room today and it was really fun. So I'll show you one that I made earlier. Okay, we'll cut that and then we'll turn that around and we're going to cut this at 3.5 inches. So the final measurement, if you're counting, 3.5 inches by 4¾ inches. Maybe I'll make sure that's right there. Okay. So for those of you, ooh, let me get full screen here so I don't have any mishaps. So for those of you that are new to Gina K Designs, you'll see this in almost all of my cards. I really, really like a very thin border. So I'm going to make a thin border for this. So because it was 4¼ inches, I'm just going to go up 1/8 of an inch from that mark. I'm going to cut. And then it was 3.5 inches. So I'm going to go 1/8 of an inch up from that mark. And that's going to give me this tiny little skinny border that I love. See how nice that looks. Okay. So now we're going to stamp. So again, I know I'm out of stock on this stamp set, but I have a lot of them coming because I know I've been using it like crazy and some of you have requested that you would like to get it. It's the Wild Blossoms stamp set and I used it in my last video. I'm going to use it for this card, but I'm going to use something else for another card. And when I use this stamp set, I really do like this, the Misty Corner. And I like that because when I use the images, I like them to kind of come off the card. So in this case, I want it to come off the card a little bit down here. And if I had this cardstock right up in the corner, I wouldn't be able to do that. You know, it would be going off of the Misty. So by popping that corner into place, I am able to get a little bit of that off the cardstock like that. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put most of this image on the card. So I really think that this image is going to be stamped more than once. So I really want to make sure that it's secure and I really want to keep the magnet on there. And I really want to say really about 4,000 more times tonight. You know, sometimes you're talking to people and you hear how many times you say the same word. Oh, I hear that all the time. Okay, so now I'm going to use some black onyx. This is just a water-based ink. You can also use amalgam ink. You can use any kind of ink really at this point because this is all dry. So I'm going to use water-based ink because it dries the fastest. And I am a messy stamper sometimes. So I'm going to ink that up and then I'm going to stamp it. Let me get my sleeve in here so I can really put pressure on. Sorry if that's shaking the feed at all. Now remember, because you're using watercolor paper, it's got a lot of indentations, so you're going to see some of that, but that's okay. I don't mind that. I actually, I think it looks good because it shows off the grain a little bit of the paper. If you absolutely hate that, then use regular cardstock for this technique. And just know it's going to be a little warpy and you're going to need probably a little bit more tape or glue. Okay, so I'm going to leave it just like that. I love these wild flowers. That's such a nice stamp. So fun. So I'm going to get my tidy towel and I'm going to clean this up before I go on. Just to get that off of there. Now you might notice that the ink stains a little bit purple on there, but I just use a little of the stamp cleaner and I spritz it on there and it'll come right off. So it'll be able to be nice and clean. I usually don't do that to the end though, because it leaves a little residue on there. And then I like to clean it again with a little bit of either Windex or soap and water, something like that. So now I'm gonna go and get this out of here because I won't need that. I'm gonna go right up into the top corner. And then I'm going to pick a greeting. Now, this is one of my other favorite stamp sets. This is called Nurturing Blooms. And I love this eucalyptus. We also have a gorgeous eucalyptus set if you like lots of layering stamps. You could use this both ways. This is the layered eucalyptus. And this has three layers, so you can do it in three different greens. But if you just want a straight ahead silhouette one, this will work. I'm going to use that in one of the cards tonight. And I'm going to use the I'm here for you greeting. I think that would be a good card for these days. And then I probably should clean my stamp that's on here and get that off so I don't have a big mess. So let me find the spot that I want to put this. Now you could put it anywhere. I mean, you could put it off to the one side, but I'm going to keep the whole focal image of my card just right in this little section right over here. So I'm going to lean over my camera here to see if that's straight. I'm here for you. And if it's not straight, then you just cut it down and make it a smaller card. Okay, pick that up. And then I'm going to use my little black onyx ink cube for this. And I do want to make sure that that's tucked in there because I might have to stamp it more than once because watercolor paper does have that rough texture. That looks pretty good. I didn't think that would work so well the first time. Okay, so that is what my card is going to look like. Now, it still looks a little bit like a mess until you really get the whole card done. And I did get a little bit of black ink here, so I'm going to just scrape that off. Try not to scrape off too much of my background. But that might be okay because that'll give me some more white spots in there. And I like the white spots. Okay. Alrighty, so now let me get rid of this greeting and then I'm gonna put this onto a black piece of cardstock. So I already cut this cardstock down and this is gonna go right onto here like this. Let me get a clean tidy towel. I actually have several tidy towels. I use them all the time. I like to have a couple because then I don't have to stop and go clean it in between. Once it gets kind of inky, then you do kind of need to go rinse it. So if I have more than one, it makes it a little easier for me. Okay, so again, because this is watercolor and because you did a lot of water on this card, you might want to use a little extra tape. So I'm going to do the full tape thing on all four sides. So it'll lay down nice and flat, and then I'm going to put a little bit of the metal. Now, you can use liquid glue.
That works too. But
tape really flattens things out if you used a lot of water. Okay. Looking good. That looks good. And then I'm going to put this onto a white card base. So let me see. I think I have a bunch of white card bases ready to go at all times. Here's one. And then this is going to go on there. Doesn't that really just make it pop once you get it on the white card base? It makes it so elegant. I think I just put ink on my nose, but we'll see. We'll look at it. Okay, so I'm going to just put a little bit of tape on this one. That was a little more than a little bit, but all right. Looks even. Even, Steven. Yes. Okay. There we go. So there's my first card. Isn't that a pretty background technique? It's really hard for me to get that look with all the white space, and it looks almost like clouds and stuff. It's really hard for me to get that look with just plain watercolor. I'm sure a lot of you can because you're good at watercolor, but I'm not. So this is like a cheater's technique for me, and I really like it. Okay, so that's one card. Now let's see what we got going on here with this. I love this background. So I'm going to do something with this one, but I want to cut this one down even more. So let me trim it down. Let me get my paper cutter. And I'm going to trim it down just a little bit more. So this one was already really tiny. It already started at 3.5. I'm going to take it down to 3.25. I think I'm going to take it down on this side to 3.25. And that's what's good about trimming it, is you can pick the side that you don't like the most, and you can cut that side off. So this is the side that I'm not as thrilled about. And then it was 4.75. I'm going to take it down to 4.5. So this is going to be a much tinier one. I'm going to lose that little bit of white space, but that's all right. I got it at the top, and that's kind of where I like it the most. Because that really, like you can see on this one, now that you have the image there, that white looks like clouds and the sky is peeking through. Okay, so now I'm going to take the Nurturing Blooms stamp set again, and I'm going to use the eucalyptus. So again, I'm going to use my Misty, so this way I can stamp it 2 or 3 times if I need to. I don't have to worry about it. And this, I also don't have to worry about, using the corner because it's not, I'm not going to go off to the side. So I can just go straight Misty up in the top corner. So I'm going to have this one down here. And I'm going to stamp that in Black Onyx. Been doing a lot of silhouette style cards lately. I've just really been into it, and I hope it's fun for you guys too. Okay. So this one inked up really nice. Let me get my sleeve going here. It's easier when I use my sleeve. Looks pretty good. I think I'm gonna leave it like that. I'm going to clean the stamp, and then I'm going to move it. So I think this time I'm going to move it like down here, and I'm going to tilt it in just a little bit. So it looks like a different stamp, even though it's the same exact stamp. It'll look a little different just at that angle. Okay. Again, you always want to reposition your cardstock and get rid of that ink, because if it's there, it'll get on me, and then it'll get somewhere I don't want it to be. All right, I'm going to ink this up again and stamp. The only reason why I put my sleeve down sometimes is because it seems to glide over the Misty better, especially when I use lotion or something on my hands. So if you pull your sleeve down and then use that, it'll glide and the pressure will be a little bit easier. Okay, and then this last one, I'll go up just a little higher. Wait, let me clean this first. Okay, I'm gonna go up just a little higher and I'm gonna tilt in the other way. So we'll go in like that and we'll tilt in toward it. And we'll stamp it off the cardstock a little bit too, just a little. Maybe I'll go up just a hair higher, like that. Okay. I'm sure that will make all the difference. Oh, we're stampers. We obsess about stuff like that. Okay. And here is the last image. Oh, yeah, I like that. So that one stamp kind of looks like 3 different stamps just because of the different angles. Get this out of the way and clean the Misty. Get my tissue again and dry it. Okay, So now I need to put my greeting on. And again, if you're new to my channel, you're going to see I do very, very clean and simple, easy cards. I'm not complex, really. I mean, if you look at my YouTube channel, you'll find more complex card ideas, but I tend to, I guess, I really just like the clean and simple. So I think here we're going to use, I know we will get through this. Isn't that the perfect greeting? Oh my gosh, I have to use that one. Okay, I know we will get through this. And I do. I do believe that. We will get through this. Together. Alone together, right? Okay. So hopefully this is straight. Because I can't make it any smaller. So if it's not, I'll tilt it and we'll pretend it's straight. All right, here we go. Nervous. Because it's live. Okay, and here we go. Oh, I think down there. We'll get through this. Yes. Yay. So there is the second panel for my second card. And welcome to anybody who's just joining us out there. We really have a lot of people here tonight. That's so fun. I just appreciate that so much, you guys. We're talking about guilt. And we've talked quite a bit about what people feel guilty about. And if you're just joining us, we talked about how, especially right now, it's pretty easy to feel guilty. I mean, you can make yourself feel guilty just for being healthy or just for having enough food right now because we see so much suffering out there. But we also talked about how guilt might not be the right emotion. And I'm going to explain that at the end. Okay, so my card was 3 1/4. So I'm going to go up 1/8. And then it was 4 1/2. I'm going to go up 1/8. And I think that's right, but we'll check it. And if it's wrong, I can recut it. I will try hard not to feel guilty. Okay, that looks right. Yay! Okay. So now I'm going to adhere these panels together. Let me find my adhesive. And again, because we used a lot of water, I'm using an extra amount of adhesive. Adhesive is very valuable to me these days. It's hard to get stuff. It's hard for us to even get a lot of our supplies in. So it's been tricky, but things are starting to trickle in a little bit, believe it or not, which is exciting. And we do have the Wild Blossoms flower stamp set, the Wild Blossoms on order. So I'm gonna just, should I trim just a hair off? Here's where the whole thing falls apart. I'm gonna try just to cut a hair off. And when I say hair, I mean really a hair, like that. See, that's the hair I'm talking about. But I feel like it's better. Okay, that's just crazy talk. All right, I need another white card base from my little stash of white card bases I have over here. I want a top fold one. And then this is a much smaller panel, but I love the big wide border. So there's the big wide border. Isn't that nice? I like that color combination too. I was a little stressed with the peach and the blue. I was hoping it wasn't gonna be too brown, but I think that they blended really nicely together. So I'm gonna add some tape on the back there and I'm going to put that right there, like that. So there's my second card. Let me show both of them together here. And you can see the color combinations. This one's a much cooler toned card. And this one's a warmer tone card, almost like a sun, kind of sunrise or sunset. But really, the space is the key. If you can get some white space to just hang out there. It really makes a huge, huge difference. So I have this other one here, and I think I'll try one more thing real quick before we close out for the night. I'm going to stamp. I have this stamp set that I used in one of my Christmas cards, one of our Merry Mondays, this little row of trees. And I think I'm going to stamp the little row of trees like right in this area, and then I'm just going to trim it up and we'll see what that looks like. I could actually, I think, will that work? Yeah, that'll work. That'll actually look pretty good. So it might hang off the page a little bit, off the cardstock, but that's okay. So let's give this a see how it looks. Okay. So I want the bottoms of the trees to look like they're kind of closer to that blue. And I might need my misty corner for this one. So I'm going to put it right here. And then we'll see how much we have to cut off, if any. We might not have to. All right. So I'm going to use black onyx again. Surprise, surprise. And ink this up. I like this because this stamp set is called the Wetlands. Is this the Wetlands 2? Lost the little pocket. It's the Wetlands 2. So what I like about this is Teresa Momber designed this stamp set, and she put like little reflections in there. So it almost looks like you've got some water around these trees or some ice and snow. Let's see if that's good enough. Oh, I think we need more. We need more, but I like the way that looks. It just changes. The whole background just absolutely changes when you add an image. It goes from just looking like a blob to like, oh, okay, I can see where the ground is now. I can see where the sun is. I can see where the clouds are. It's pretty cool. Okay. All right, I like that. And again, this is that other weird watercolor paper that I kind of like, but it's definitely a more puckery paper. That is not a word, but you know what I'm talking about, right? It's got more dents in it. So the first two were the Tim Holtz cardstock. All right, let's see. What kind of greeting? I feel like it needs just like a straight across greeting. How about if I just cut this whole thing out and I make that like the focal image? I make the focal image like up here. No, I don't want to do that. All right, I'm gonna just trim it and I'm gonna make it a straight up and down card. I'm telling you, I'm flying by the seat of my pants most nights here, guys. Okay, so we'll cut this down to, we'll cut a little off of each side here so we can get it to that 3.5. So make it 3.5. Hopefully I'm not messing this up too much. And then this is going to go to 4.25. So I think I'm going to cut it mostly off at the bottom because I don't really like the bottom as much. Although now I do kind of like it now. And then I'm going to put my greeting up here. Okay. So let's find a nice greeting for this. And there are some pretty nice greetings in this stamp set already. And don't forget, I know that we're all making cards for people that we miss and that we're thinking about, but don't forget there's birthdays coming up and people aren't feeling well, so feel better soon. But I like this one, you're still the one. So Tom's birthday's coming up soon. I'm gonna say you're still the one, because he is. We just celebrated our anniversary. All of these stamps in here would be perfect for this technique. I like this set. You're still the one. How cute is that? I know you're all singing that song now too, aren't you? Because I am in my head. Still the one that can scratch my itch. Oh, I remember laughing at that song when I was a kid. All right. Here we go. You're still the one. Oh, I need my sleeve. Yeah. Okay. And so this, and of course you could use any stamp for any occasion, but I like greeting. This makes me giggle. Okay, so I'm gonna use some black cardstock again. And then I had that white card base, so let's move this out of the way. So my verdict is that I like the Tim Holtz cardstock better. And I think it's probably a little easier to get at your craft store, at your local craft store. And I know a lot of local craft stores are still doing curbside, which is fun. And I did want to talk to you while I'm doing this is I wanted to talk to you about, I had posted something earlier about Wisconsin is changing some of their stay-at-home mandate. They have like a new one going to into effect, but it's a little bit different. But it doesn't affect the fact that we can still take orders and we can still ship orders, which is great. So I did want you to know that we are still picking and packing and shipping orders. And I also wanted to let you know that we have a part of our website. If you go to the Gina K Designs website, there is a tab on there that says our retailers. And our retailers are the different stores that carry Gina K Designs stamps. And if you scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll find all of our international retail partners where you can find our stamps. So if you're looking, you know, you're watching from another country and you wish that our stamps were close by, they very well may be. So just check that tab out. But we do ship worldwide as well. Okay, so this is going on to another white card base. And that will be my final card for tonight. I just felt like I had to make something with it because we made the background. So I thought that that would be a good one to use. And of course, any solid stamp, any scene type of stamps work great with these techniques. So let me grab these cards again and bring them in so you can see them. This was the first one we did. I'm Here For You, and this used the Wild Blossoms stamp set. And then we have this one that used the Wetlands 2, and this one that used Nurturing Blooms. Well, that was a lot of fun to do and very, very different looks based on what cardstock you use. Well, that was really fun. Well, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed those cards tonight. I really do. I hope that you'll give some of these this a try, and I'd love to see what you guys are doing. So make sure that if you're on Facebook, we have a great Facebook group. It's called Gina K Designs and Stamp TV Friends, and you can share your versions of these cards. Now, we do have some rules in our group, and I wanted to just mention that here because we had a little bit of confusion. It is a Gina K Designs group. So in our rules, you'll see that we require you to use Gina K Designs stamps and products in your card projects. But we also know that we are in some unprecedented times right now, and not everybody has Gina K Designs stamps. You might stencil that's ours. You might just want to try this technique and share your version of it. So we're being a little lenient with our rules, and we aren't pulling down those posts right now. But we certainly would appreciate if you say in your description that this is my version of the card from Flashback Friday Live. This way our moderators know why you're posting cards that don't use the Gina K Designs stamps. Once we're all back and we're out and we're getting together again, our rules will go back to being a Gina K Designs only group. But right now we are being a little bit lenient if you would like to share your versions of any of our live cards. So the topic tonight was guilt, and I was talking earlier about all of the different things that we feel guilty about, and so much of them, guilt is just the wrong feeling. So if you just join me, I also said I'm not a therapist, but I see a therapist twice a week. And at one of my appointments, I was talking about guilt and how I feel guilty for so many things. And my therapist said this to me. And he said this to me, and like a light bulb went off in my head. And if I apply this to everything I'm feeling guilty about, so many times I can just let that go. And this is what he said to me. He said, it's appropriate to feel guilt when we do something that violates our morals and values. Otherwise, it's likely unjustified or inappropriate guilt. And I just went like, poof. So for example, if I cheat on my husband, I should feel guilty. That's appropriate guilt because that violates my morals and values. I don't believe that I should cheat on my husband. And if I do, I feel like I've done something wrong that violates my morals and values. But if I feel guilty because I'm healthy, that's wrong. That's unjustified guilt. It's inappropriate. I shouldn't feel guilty for being healthy. I should ask myself that question. Is this something that violates my morals or values? And if it doesn't, it's likely unjustified or inappropriate guilt. So you're going to find that quote on my Facebook page, and my Facebook page is public. Anybody can see anything that I post. It's Gina Aurelio Krupski. So you can find me on Facebook. I'm going to say it one more time. It's appropriate to feel guilt when we do something that violates our morals or values. Otherwise, it's likely unjustified or inappropriate guilt. So now next time you feel guilty, as you start to feel that sick feeling, like, oh, I don't, did you violate your morals and values? If you didn't, you shouldn't feel guilty. All right, you guys, thank you so much for joining me. I love you all so very much. I'll see you back here on Monday for Merry Monday. We'll be making some fun Christmas card projects together. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you again soon.